Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and this video is less of a full tutorial and more of an FYI. So if you are the sort of person who uses large language models, AI chatbots, not that often, but when you do, you want to get the best results, like obviously you do. So you want to use the best models, you don't want to be rate limited, that sort of thing. I find apps like ChatWise to be really useful because basically what they let you do is access pretty much the most recent models of everything from ChatGPT to Claude to Gemini to even more, but without having to pay $20 per month every month, which can be pretty steep, especially if you don't use these tools a ton. And so the idea of these basically, and the idea of ChatWise, is you download ChatWise and then in the settings, you can add your own API keys from each of those large language model providers. And then you can run requests on them. So we're going to take a look at how this works with kind of a basic example. I will mention pricing because I always mention pricing. ChatWise is free, but I did pay for the pro one. It's a one-time $29 fee. It says $49 normally, but I don't think it's ever $49. So it's a $29 app. Artifacts is the big thing for me I wanted to have, which is basically it makes it better for code generation, which I tend to do quite a bit with these. I really like to use large language models to generate scripts and little basic websites for myself. Really, really nice for that sort of thing. So let's take a look at how you generate a key first, and then we'll show the app in a second. So I'm gonna show you Anthropic. It's a similar process for ChatGPT or Gemini or any of these. Basically just Google Gemini API key, OpenAI API, but whatever. Anthropic.com/API is where we're at now. If I hit start building, I would have to register. I've already registered, so there's no need for me to do that. And basically, I go into my settings, go into billing, and this is where your balance lives for what you have on your account. So I have $23.45 of credit right now. Basically, I put $25 on the account a few weeks ago. I haven't spent that much of it. And I can add funds at any time. I can set up auto renew. So if I get to a certain amount, when my balance reaches a certain number, I can add this much credit. I don't want to do that. If I go over 25, I just want it to stop working and then I'll add it when I'm ready. But anyway, let's remember that number, 2345. Oh, that's actually really convenient. Good. So we're going to hide that. And now we're looking at ChatWise. And so the UI is pretty similar. You're going to notice the chat history over here on the left with different icons for which model I used to do things. And you can see I've been favoring Gemini for some stuff just to kind of test it out. But yeah, let's go ahead and create a new one here. And I've already got 3.5 Sonnet. Oh, I should also mention how it works. Let's go to settings, go to providers, and go to Anthropic. You can see I've already pasted in my key. And it's just going to work. You can do this for any of these models listed here. You can see I've done it for Google AI as well. And there's a few more you can add if it's not on this list. So Anthropic, again, is the one we're doing. I went to anthropic.com/API, created an account, added some credits, and generated a key, copied it, pasted it here. So now that we have that, let's go ahead and paste in a request. Ooh, and there's an update available for the app right here. Basically, I'm going to ask it to generate a simple HTML page with some vanilla JavaScript that is a daily task manager. So just let me create some tasks to do today. Let me mark them as complete. And then at the start of the next day, clear out everything from the previous one and just tell me how many things we've completed. So it's going to write the code over here. And this is very similar to if you use Claude on the web. You're going to recognize this kind of interface with code on the right and the explanation on the left. Looks like it's done. And it's going to start explaining the code here on the left side for me. Looking good, looking fine. Cool. And if I go into preview this, now I can see I have this little thing here. So let's add a task. Make video, write script, email sponsor. There's no sponsor of this video, but in theory I could. And there's my three to-dos, right? So let's say I already wrote the script. I made the video and I've emailed the sponsor. Great, those are done. And then I'm not gonna make you wait hours for me to see this the next day. But in theory, I should see a little UI element that tells me that I completed three tasks today. I can of course add more. And it works great. I really love using these models for simple stuff like this where just very little tools that I need and I can work with them, right? And so I can go ahead and copy the code to my clipboard and I can paste this into an HTML file and just run it locally on my computer. Love this. This works great. And now let's go ahead and take a look at how much that cost me, right? Like I just used, that's a relatively beefy request. It generated, how much code is this? A couple hundred lines? Yeah, 269 lines of code, relatively lengthy explanation as to what it did. How much did that cost me? So 2345, if we reload, 2340, 5 cents. So it cost me 5 cents to generate this tool. That's not bad, right? So if we do $20 divided by 0.05, I could do this 400 times in a month and come out even with what Claude Pro would cost. Like, that's pretty darn good. So I'm quite happy with the value here because I'm not generating something this big every time. Let's do a second request for, does this comply with, although this might actually edit the code. Yeah, so it's regenerating the code, so this won't be a small request. This will be a similar sized request. So it's going to show still generating while the code's coming out. If we go over to it, then we should see it rendering. And again, it's going to work in the background. We'll let it kind of do its thing, but this I would expect to cost me about 5 cents as well. So yeah, these requests really don't add up. And Claude, I'm showing because Claude is famously, I think at this point, the most expensive LLM to run. Like it's very, very expensive, like an order of magnitude more expensive than some of the other models from OpenAI and Google. So yeah, this is about as expensive as it gets. If you put money into your Google account or your OpenAI account, you're going to get even more than this most likely. So let's reload again, about 5 cents. Oh, that didn't cost anything, or maybe it just hasn't updated yet. We'll see. It certainly costs something. But yeah, so now it should be more accessible. And yeah, if we do, I'm going to reload again because that can't be right. Yes, that costs 7 cents. So that was a little bit more. When is Christmas? This should just tell me that. So it's being pretty verbose with its response here. That's more than I needed. But yeah, let's see how much that cost. So 33 cents. That one cost 2 cents. So yeah, it's a couple pennies per request on the most expensive model I can find. So yeah, pretty darn cheap in the grand scheme of things. And yeah, I think it's pretty good. If we go into settings again, there's a few options here. Providers is kind of the big one where you provide the keys that you want to be available. There's some stuff here that I don't understand. I haven't messed with. Yeah, I don't fully understand what this is. I have enabled web search through Tavily. So I have added an API key for that. It's free up to like 1,000. Let's see. Let me go in here. Up to 1,000 credits. I've used 13, and I think it'll just cut off. I don't have a card on file for this, so it should just die when it fails. Let's just try that. Let's do a new search. We're going to stick with Claude just because Claude does not have web search. ChatGPT does, Google I think does, and so Claude is the one that doesn't. If we enable web search, let's do what interesting tech news happened yesterday. I actually have no idea what's going to happen here. Searching for the news on February 13th, which was yesterday as of recording, and so it's found some results, and it's giving me these, so I can hover over the citations, and yeah, it's pulling in actual things. So cool. I can use... That didn't work. So yeah, maybe this update will fix everything. But yeah, some of these didn't quite work exactly right. I think I can click in here. Yeah, and then these are just a list of the cited sources. Oh, I wonder if that's it. There's only 5 that it shows here, and it kept citing things after 5. Yeah. Interesting. So is that a hallucination that there's more? I don't know. This is the danger of using LLMs for everything. But yeah, that is my tip. If you want to use the best models and you don't want to be rate limited, you don't want to not have the best models because you're only on the free tier and you don't think $20 a month is worth it to you, load up some credits on one of these models and just use the API key through one of these apps, and you'll be able to use them to their full ability and not have to pay a ton every single month. You can generate entire websites for 5 cents. That's pretty darn good, in my opinion. So that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.